everyone, it's Haley, and today I'm going to be doing a spoiler-free review of The Winner's Curse by Marie Rutkoski. So this book follows Kestrel, who is the daughter of a general in this warmongering country that has overtaken another country and enslaved all of the people, all the former citizens of that country. So Kestrel ends up buying a slave, and she ends up kind of feeling more for him than she really should, and it just leads to a very interesting story. So this book has a lot of hype surrounding it, and I did get my hopes up a little bit, and unfortunately they were quite let down. Overall, I gave this book a 2.75 stars, and here is why. So to start out on a positive note, Marie Rutkoski's writing is genuinely very, very enjoyable. Her writing style is really nice. I really enjoyed her word choice and everything, and the flow of everything was really nice and easy to read. It was really engaging, and I would read more from her in the future. I'm just not sure if I'm going to continue with this series. I might. I'll get to that more later, though. So that being said, the writing was beautiful, but the plot did not do it justice at all. So basically this book starts out like really slow, like nothing really happens, and then all of a sudden stuff happens and it just goes woo, lots of stuff happening, and then all of a sudden it's just done. Like really weird. It was very, the rising action and the climax and everything was just kind of all at once, and I was like, what? So one of the main things that made this book like a little bit boring was one, the spacing of the action, and two, the underdevelopment of elements of the plot. So what would happen was you would have like, she would say, oh, I'm mad at him, and then it would be at the beginning of the chapter, and then the next page she'd be like, well, maybe I'm not. Like, I was just like, what was the point of that at all? It didn't add to the story at all. I mean, nothing was like, why would you do that? Because like, it just was kind of there, it was introduced, but then nothing happened with it after, and it was just really, really odd. And they even did this with some of the people who died. I mean, I was just, what? So I do want to touch upon this a little bit because it is one of the main topics of this book, and that is slavery. So obviously slavery is like one of the big plot themes of this book, but how it was dealt with, I did not like at all. I felt like it was dismissed. It was like, yeah, these people are slaves, but whatever. I mean, it's just kind of their life. The main character, Kestrel, she's kind of, from the synopsis, you would guess that she's someone who is going to stand up against the, like, regime and slavery and be like, no, this is wrong. These people shouldn't be treated like that because they're no, like, we're no better than they are. But it's really not like that. All she really does in defiance of her father and kind of the slave regime is she falls in love with a slave. Like, that's really the only thing she does to try and fix the slave problem. She just wants to be able to be with him. It was just really off-putting. Like, what happened is the Valorians, they have conquered the Harani people, and the Haranis, they are now the slaves of the Valorians. And the Haranis really are treated like dirt, but they act really submissive to their conditions. And I understand, like, I'm not gonna get into slavery in real life at all because that's just a whole nother topic and a whole nother controversy. But I just felt like how submissive they were was a little bit, it didn't match the synopsis. You think this is going to be a book where you see someone who is oppressed by their conditions and then they rise up against it with the help of one of their oppressors. But that's not what this book is at all, and that was just kind of disappointing for me. Another thing that was annoying is that all of the slaves were presented as very one-dimensional characters. There were only two, like, mostly one, the one that she falls in love with, obviously. And then there was a woman slave that you kind of got a closer look at, but none of them you really got to see, like, what their life was like before, what it's like now, other than the main character that was a slave. You didn't get to see that for any of them. And it was just really, I felt like we should have been able to see more into the conditions of the slaves, because when you're reading it from the perspective of one of the oppressors, it's hard to see how their treatment is wrong, because it's not really written as if it were wrong to be doing that, if that made sense at all. And what really annoyed me as well was that any instance where the slave would start standing up against their master, the slave was presented as villainous. And I understand that it's being written from the perspective of, like, one of the people who believes in this system of slavery, but I didn't like it because it didn't match what the synopsis was kind of presenting the book as. And to me, I feel like the synopsis should match the book, and it didn't. It was just kind of selling me a completely different story than what I got. So usually for a book, the characters can be a redeeming factor, but this one, absolutely not. The characters were all annoying, all kind of assholes, and oh my god. The main character, Kestrel, is just self-centered, annoying, can't make any decisions. She's just kind of a little brat, and I really could not stand her. And obviously, since she is the protagonist of this book, it's going to focus on her struggles. But the first three quarters of this book were so boring because the main struggle was that her father, since he's a general, her father wants her to join the army and enlist in the army, but she wants to play piano. What? Like, how do you write a story off of that? That's just, it was just so, so boring. I just, like, what? Really, the romance and the slave action plot doesn't really pick up until the book is basically done. It was just the fact that she was so apathetic to everything, and she didn't want slavery to really end, it didn't seem like to me. She just wanted to be able to stay with her man who just happens to be a slave. So the only reason she would want slavery to be abolished was because she wants to, like, for selfish reasons, because she wants to be with this guy. So annoying. Like, what? What? And then we have Aaron, who is the main slave and the one that she falls in love with. And by the way, that's not a spoiler. It says it literally right in the synopsis, so you're fine. And he is the only slave that we are actually given an insight into his life, into his struggles now, and into kind of what he was like before and what happened to his family and everything. So that's great. But then everything is just kind of discredited by the fact that he is a grade A asshole. He is super annoying. He's selfish too. Like, he's basically like Kestrel, but like more of an asshole. And that bugged me because he was portrayed as this villain and he's the only slave that we get to see into their life. So these slaves, they are just basically these villainous characters, and the people who are enslaving them are portrayed as they're good. They're the ones who, like, they have been terrorized by these slaves and blah, blah, blah. Like, no. Oh my god, just, I'm getting so heated about this. I just can't. Like, him and Kestrel should not be together at all, because it just doesn't work. So other than the political intrigue of the plot, it was pretty boring. There wasn't really much else to it, and I was like, why? Why did I read this? So, that being said, The Winner's Crime, the sequel with the gorgeous cover, I'll put a picture of it right here, that is coming out next year. And I think I might read it because this book had so much potential to be great. And I think she might be able to get it right in the second one. I am hoping that she can, because this story could be really, really amazing. It's just, it kind of just fell flat in this book because it was dull, the characters were not written as enjoyable, and some of the topics weren't dealt with properly, at least I feel like. So, I know a lot of people really loved this book. I'm not really on the love side. So, please don't hate me for my opinion, it just wasn't my thing. But if you did love it, that's awesome for you. I think I might give the second one a try, maybe give this one a second chance. I don't know. I really don't know right now. So that is all for my review of The Winner's Curse by Marie Rutkoski. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye!